Lakhs of medical students every year wait for the chance to appear in the NEET UG exam so that they can get a chance to enter the medical field and also the medical colleges of their choices that they've dreamt of and also worked really hard for. The entry point for these admissions is the NEET UG exam, which this year has sparked a huge controversy. Various allegations have been made by students across the country of alleged malpractices and irregularities, not just in conducting of the exam, but also the way the results were announced. One issue that has been flagged is the fact that grace marks were awarded by NTA only to 1563 students. Now, the NTA has said that it has found a solution to deal with this particular grievance and has told the Supreme Court that a retest will be conducted only for these 1563 students. We are being joined by the petitioner who, before Supreme Court, had challenged this grace mark aspect and NTA's decision. How do you see the stand that NTA has taken? Do you think it, in a way, solves the grievance that you had flagged before the top court?
First of all, NTA has accepted that what the grievance committee recommendations are wrong, and they have withdrawn the recommendations and the grace marks. They said that they will organize the exam again for the 1500 students. But we are not at all happy with this. It is a good sign that NTA has accepted its mistake. But the other thing is that the students who weren't approached by the High Court or Supreme Court, they didn't get the justice. Many students cannot afford to go to Supreme Court or High Court. We also demand that they should open a window so that the students who have suffered from time lapse should again approach and write a re-exam. And there are many discrepancies in all the process from beginning. We have seen that at least four discrepancies which we have challenged in court. First thing is that the application for registration was closed and it was opened after 20 days for 2 days. We asked the court, why was it opened? We asked NTA, why was it opened? For whom it was opened? The second thing is that it has been a very popular thing that NTA question papers are being leaked since many years. Not only this, but CUET paper was also leaked previous year. They have responded that paper was leaked only in Jaipur or Rajasthan. In this era of information technology, within few seconds, any paper leaked in one state or one place can go viral all over the world. There are many things which we have raised. We also demand that SIT should be SIT committee should be made under independent committee should be made under the Supreme Court. We should investigate all the discrepancies and punish whoever has found culprit to these discrepancies.
We're also being joined by some of the aspirants who had appeared in this year's NEET UG exam. Ma'am, according to you, what are the biggest issues that students have faced as far as this entire NEET controversy and NEET this year is concerned?
Ma'am, the main issue would be obviously the rank inflation that has occurred, and that the main reason for the rank inflation is actually the leaks, not the grace marks that the NTA has used as a disguise to hide their acts while they were involved in the leaks themselves. Because see, in Patna, in Godhra, both these states, we have seen the FIRs were filed, students were arrested. My only question is, if this was such a transparent organization, only 1563 candidates who got grace marks, and these were only the kids who had gone to the court to explain their time losses. There's hundreds of candidates who went through the same thing, but they didn't go to the court because they didn't know that they would get their justice only through court. Because we believed in the NTA, because it is the conducting examination body, but they are playing with us. We have already mailed them so many times that why did this happen? They're only saying only because of grace marks. You tell me, if out of 2.4 million kids, only 1563 candidates are even removed, will we get our justice? Will the rank inflation, will there be any change? There will be no change because the main case is the leak. And it has been done before as well. If one student is caught in leak, the entire exam gets cancelled. The entire examination has to be held again. Again, if they say that re-evaluation is the only key, then I demand that the CBI needs to intervene here. They need to go through a ground and a thorough investigation so that each and every culprit is caught. And see, so many candidates, not just from our country, but from abroad, they come to India. Why do they come to India? Because our country is known to make some promising doctors. And these promising doctors are being replaced by quacks. These are the kids who barely qualified. And we keep saying that grace, grace, grace. 240 marks race approximately. Okay, 171 marks the kids that were scoring. They got the paper day earlier. They learnt it all. They got the marks. They're getting the seat. How is that justified? This is my only question. And the NTA needs to answer this. And I believe that the Honorable Supreme Court will go through more hearings today. And after that, they might change their decision and put a stay on counseling because that is very important. 6th July, they say that counseling will start. 8th July, the Supreme Court is going to answer us. There's a saying, justice delayed is justice denied. And that is happening in real life. We need to put a stay on counseling. We need to cancel the examination. And 200 crores they profited off the examination that they held this year. They have so much capital left. Why can't they reconduct the examination again? And if they're holding the committee, why are they holding the committee by themselves? Why not an independent external agency? As far as you mentioned about stay on the counselling, the High Court has denied a stay, so has the Supreme Court. So there's no question of stay on the counselling as of now. The court has today very clearly said that if the exam goes, if they decide against the exam itself, the counselling goes altogether. What do you think about that? Ma'am, the sanctity is still breached of the examination, right? Even if you don't put a stay on counselling, then tell me, these are the kids who are going to make the future for the country. They're going to make the name of ourselves. Our country's image is going to go down. And it's not just the country, it is a matter of students. How can you not give justice to your students? And if they need to put a stay on counselling, because if they don't do that, then all those kids who were involved in leaks, all those rich kids who gave so shell out, who could shell out so much money, why didn't they just go for private? Why are they depriving us of our seats?
CBI investigation is what she has said is a solution. What about you? What do you think were the main problems that as somebody who's appeared in the examination, you must know other people also who appeared. Exactly. What are the problems? What is the biggest problem that you think students have faced this particular year?
This particular year, the cutoff has been so high that even 650 marks, I scored 650 marks and I am not getting college in any medical college in any state of India. We used to put 650 marks on pedestal till last year. We used to ask the students how to score 650 marks. And right now, even the colleges are not asking us. Isn't this unfair? Look, this whole scenario is being it's being shifted to the 1563 candidates who were given grace marks. But what about us? We have given the examination with our full confidence and we have scored good marks. 650 is really good score, but still we are not able to get medical college. How is this fair? What about those kids, what about those students that would go to a medical college and by buying medical seats? Supreme Court has passed a judgment in 2015 that even if a single student has got unfair marks, the whole exam should be cancelled. Why didn't the NDA use that judgment? Why did they use the judgment of 2018? There are approximately 15,000 students between 610 and 660 marks. This year 660 marks is the cutoff. Last year it was 610. So it is the whole scenario is about these students. What about these students? They won't get justice by just cancelling these 1563 candidates. What about us? Once the counselling starts, who will look after us?
Okay. Most of these petitions have raised questions of irregularities, malpractices, unfair means. Supreme Court is going to hear those cases in July. What are your expectations from the Supreme Court as far as these matters are concerned?
As for my expectation, I expect that Supreme Court will do the right thing here and give us justice. And as for these cases that have been going on in our country, these harm the sanctity of this exam, which is the major biggest exam of this country as of now. The second biggest is JEE Mains, and in this exam 24 lakh people this year registered, which is twice that of the second major exam, JEE Main. So this big exam, and then they are saying that there was no leaks. First, they have denied any leaks on the 5th of May when in the evening when there was a case of leak, and they denied it completely. Then after now, they are saying okay, there were leaks, but it wasn't a major leak, and we won't consider it as a leak, and that there will be no case of re-neat. So my question is, why haven't you investigated it? Why haven't you given the investigation to an outsource so that we as students, as aspirants, can be satisfied with the justification? And their justification was so delayed. There were no transparency in their justification. And the first justification that they gave was that the competition has risen to such a level that this is the reason for this mass discrepancy. you tell me if previous year the level of exam was almost the same. Previous year, if the cutoff was a 610, does it make sense that the cutoff this year is 660? It doesn't make any sense. It's a really big disturbance. If it had gone to 620 or 625, we could have expected that, yes, it could have happened. But this is a major disturbance, and the reasoning that NTA has given is totally quack. It's really, it's not justification.
Lastly, today's order where retests for 1563 students who were given grace marks, what do you think about that? Because there was also an argument in court that it's unfair to the other students who won't be given the same chance. What do you think about NTA's stand?
The decision to conduct the exam again for the 1563 students is not up to the mark, I guess, because the inflations were so much that if you even remove those 1563 students, then also it will make no difference, because you see a good government college goes up to max 15,000 rank or 20,000 rank, but there are many students in having marks of 665, 655, 650 and ranks are 21,000, 20,000 and 26,000 also. So if you remove those 1563 students, then also it won't make any difference, because anyways they are not getting a government seat. Then students did not waste their 1 year and they did not get 600 plus marks just to give 1 crore marks, even after studying sincerely for 2 years, 3 years. So there are many 4 times dropper, 5 times dropper, even 6 times dropper. So what about those? So I don't think the decision to conduct the exam again for those, only those 1563 students, is a right one. And even the counseling should have been all stayed, because going not pausing the counseling means you have accepted this result, and this result doesn't make any sense.
Are you satisfied with what NTA's stand has been till now? Because they have given explanations with regard to all the concerns that are being raised by the students, be it high score, be it high cutoff ranks, be it the extra marks that they've given as compensatory marks. They have given their explanations. Are you satisfied with how NTA has acted till now?
No, not at all. I am not satisfied by the NTA's actions, because NTA's actions, they contradict their own words. They say that in competitive exam no grace mark should be given, then they are themselves giving the grace marks in a competitive exam which is conducted on a pan India level. Then I don't think NTA is being transparent even now also. They should provide CCTV footages, they should provide evidences on where the time has been lost, because if you see in Jhajjar, the principal has already denied that there was no time loss. First they claimed there were many petitions to the High Court in Delhi, Gujarat, Haryana claiming time loss, but now from Jhajjar the decision has come that there was no time loss. So now it is on NTA to provide us the transparent, foolproof evidence to the people, because whom we are trusting? We are trusting the Supreme Court, we are trusting the NTA, and we are trusting the government. Because right now NTA is the exam conducting body, and they are conducting an exam which will produce doctors to the future. So how can they do not stick to their morals? I'm surprised by their actions.
Thank you so much for speaking to us. These were the aspirants, and as we heard, all of them have very clearly said that they're not satisfied with the way the exam was conducted, the results were declared, and also not satisfied with the way the National Testing Agency handled this entire situation. Now, whether or not these allegations of irregularities are correct or not is something that only time will tell. The matters are still pending before the Supreme Court, but what remains to be seen is also whether or not NTA will be able to find a solution to the satisfaction of thousands of students who have appeared for NEET UG and have raised these grievances. With camera person Ankit from New Delhi, this is Srishti Ojha, India Today.